Hi, in this video we are going to see how to find all pair shortest path in a graph using Floyd-Warshall algorithm. So this Floyd-Warshall algorithm is also known as all pair shortest path algorithm, and it is used to find transitive closure for a graph. That means if you are taking a transitive closure for a set, it is a relation R which is giving the smallest transitive relation that contains R. Right. So, for a graph, if you are taking two vertices A and B, that A and B is belonging to, the value for A and B is belonging to R star if and only if there is a path of H from A to B. So, the same concept we are going to find here in Floyd-Warshall. Here we are going to find the smallest path from H of the vertices A to other vertices B. Right. So, let's see an example. Here we are having a graph. This is a directed graph, and each one is also, each of the vertices are, the vertices are 1, 2, 3, and each of the edges are associated with some cast. So the cast of the vertices are the weights which is associated with it, and if there is no edge from one vertex to another vertex, we can make it as infinity. And for the self loop, if you don't have any, you don't have any self loop for these vertices, so the cast of 1, 1, 2, 2, and 3, 3 is 0 here. So let's start with writing adjacency matrix for this graph. This adjacency matrix or cast matrix is given here. Here we are not taking it as adjacency matrix. Here we are taking this as cast matrix A0, which was given here. There are 3 vertices, so 3 columns and 3 rows. Right, and there is no self loop, so 1, 1, 2, 2, and 3, 3 is 0. Now we have to see, is there any edge from 1, 2, 2? So what is the cast? It's 4. So there is an edge, so its cast is 4. And similarly 1, 2, 3, 11 is there. And 2, 2, 1, so 2, 2, 1, 6 is there, so 6. And 2, 2, 3, 2. And 3, 2, 1, 3. But 3 to 2, there is no edge. So we are mentioning here as infinity. There is no direct path, right? Now we have to find, the in Floyd-Warshall algorithm, we have to find whether this direct edge's cost is less, or if we are using any intermediate vertex, will that cost will be lesser? That's what we are going to see, right? We are going to take minimum out of it. So let's start with this. First we are trying to find the cast if we use 1 as the intermediate vertex, then 2, then 3, like that for all the n vertices we have to, on n vertices we have to try. Okay, so if you take 1 as an intermediate vertex, now we are going to see what is the cast to traverse from each one of the vertices to other vertices. So 1, 2, 3 is the row and column values here. Now there is a node intermediate vertex in the self self traversal, right? A self city traversal, right? It is either city or the vertices, right? So there is no value associated in the diagonal. And if you are taking 1 as an intermediate vertex, already 1 is already involved here. So the column for 1 should be copied as such, and the row for 1 should be copied as such, right? So that means 1, 2, 1, 1, 2, 2, 1, 2, 3. Already 1 is involved, and we cannot make 1 as an intermediate vertex here. Similarly, the destination 1, 1, 1, 2, 2, 1, and 3, 2, 1. Already 1 is there. We cannot make 1 as an intermediate vertex. Now, we have to see what is the cost to move from 2 to 3 using 1 as an intermediate vertex. For that, we have to refer the previous thing, right? So the previous cost matrix A0. We are going to find what is the cost to move from 2 to 3, right? And what is the cost if you are using 1 as an intermediate vertex? So we are taking the cost to move from 2 to 1 and the cost to move from 1 to 3. So let's refer this. What is the cost to move from 2 to 3? 2 is there, right? And what is the cost to move from 2 to 1? 2 to 1 is 6. The cost of moving from 1 to 3 is 3, right? And the cost of moving from 1 to 3 is 11, so 11, so it is 17, which is lesser, 2 is lesser. So we are copying this, right? We have, our objective is to find the shortest path, right? So here the directed edge is having less cost when comparing to use 1 as an intermediate vertex. Now we are checking for 3, 2. A0 of 3 comma 2 we have to refer. If you are using a 1 as an intermediate vertex, then we have to find the cast of A0 of 3 comma 1 plus A0 of 1 comma 2. So what is A0 of 3 comma 2? It is infinity, right? And what is the cast of 3 to 1? Cast of 3 to 1 is 3. And the cast of 1 to 2 is 4. Right, so cast of 1 to 2 is 4, which is lesser, 7 is lesser. So infinity, when comparing to 7, this is lesser, so we are copying 7 here. So the shortest path from 3 to 2 is using 1 as an intermediate vertex. So 3 to 1, 3 to 1 is 3 plus 1 to 2, 1 to 2 is 4, totally 7 is the shortest path for moving from 3 to 2. Right, now we have to check if we use 2 as an intermediate vertex, what is the cast of it. So again we have to draw the matrix, cast matrix 1 2 3 1 2 3, right? And as 2 is involved, we can copy the previous cast matrix second row value and second column value, because 2 is already involved here. As I told you, the diagonal values are 0. Now we have to find what is the cast of 1, 2, 3. So for that, we have to refer the previous cast matrix. A1 of 1, 3 and A1 of 1, 2 plus A1 of 2, 3. Okay, because we are using 2 as an intermediate vertex. So if you are taking A1 of 1, 3, the value is 11. A1 of 1, 2 is 4. So 4 and 2, 3 is 6. 2. So 2. Right? So the total value is 6. Which is lesser? 6 is lesser. So the cost of traversing from 1 to 3 using 2 as an inter through 2 or via 2 is smallest one. So 6 is copied here. Now A1 of 3, 2. That means 3, 1 we have to take. So 3, 1. So A1 of 3, 1 we have to take, that value is 3, right? Now if we use 2 as an intermediate vertex, let's see, right? So that means A1 of 3, 2 plus A1 of 2, 1, right? So A1 of 3, 2 is 7, A1 of 2, 1 is 6. Right, so 13 is coming, right? So which is smallest? 3 is smallest, so we are copying 3 here, right? Now we have to find what is the cast if you are using 3 as an intermediate vertex. So let's take the same cast matrix 1 2 3, and here also 1 2 3. As I told you, as 3 is already involved, let's copy the third row value as such and third column value as such. So 6 to 0 and the diagonal values 0s as such. Now we have to find what is the cast of 1, 2. So for that we have to refer the previous matrix A2 of 1, 2 and A2 of 1, 3 plus A2 of 3, 2. So because we are taking 3 as an intermediate matrix, so A2 of 1, 2 is 4, right? And A2 of 1, 3, 1, 3 is 6 and A2 of 3, 2 is 7. So 6 plus 7 is 13 and 4 is lesser, so we are taking 4 as the smallest value. Now we have to find what is the cast of A2 of 2, 1. So A2 of 2, 1 and A2 of 2, 3 plus A2 of 3, 1. Right? We are using via third vertex, right? So A2 of 2, 1 is 6. Right? And A2 of 2, 3 is 2. And 3, 1 is 3. So 2 plus 3 is 5, which is lesser than 6. So 5 is the cast. Right? So First one, we are taking the cast without any intermediate vertex. Second one, using one as an intermediate vertex. For each one of these is having the path from 1 to 2 via 1, 1 to 3 via 1, like that, right? And here 2 is an intermediate vertex and here 3 is an intermediate vertex. So as we have completed all the vertices, now we are having the final vertex, which matrix, which is telling the smallest path from each one of the vertices to another vertices. So here we are creating 4 cast matrices. The first one is the normal given matrices. In these 3, we are running for 3 times. As we are having 3 vertices, so we are running for 3 times. So the loop will be for n number of times. And for each of the vertices, we are calculating value for all the vertices, 2 vertices, right? So n square times we are doing calculation. So n square for n number of times. So the total time complexity is, worst time complexity is order of n square for n number of vertices. So big O of n cube. So let's see the algorithm, how to write algorithm for this. So what did we do first? We are writing the cast matrix, right? So first we have to find the cast matrix. So for I is equal to 1 to n, for j equal to 1 to n, we are finding the cast and we are assigning it to AFI comma j. And every time when you are calculating this using vertex 1, vertex 2 and vertex 3, we are referring the previous value. So what did we do? We are checking the cast of the previous value and the cast using 1 as a vertex. So let's take a loop for n number of times we have to do now. So for k equal to 1 to n, and in each of these vertices we are calculating for all the I values and all the j values. So for I equal to 1 to n, for j equal to 1 to n, we are finding the previous a of I comma j, right? Previous a of I comma j, this is this square, and if you are using k as the intermediate, a of I comma k plus a of k comma j, out of this which is minimum, that will be copied in a of I comma j. So this is repeating for 3 vertices. So k equal to 1 to n, n number of vertices. So as this is having 3 loops, no? So order of big O of n cube is the time complexity. That's all. Thank you.